Transcontinental Company's business track record will bring music to your ears when it comes to experience in capturing the teen market. Founded by Louis J. Pearlman, a name now synonymous with the music industry, Transcontinental introduced the world to hugely successful music groups, hit TV shows, and a feature film packed with stars. And that's just the beginning.
I'm going to introduce you to a man with a golden touch, a modern-day Midas.
King of Pop has actually been Michael Jackson's title for some time now, but now some people are beginning to apply it to a new king who isn't a singer or a performer and who has no musical training at all.
Meet Lou Pearlman.
All right, how you doing, good?
Founder and CEO of the Transcontinental Companies, a billion-dollar teen music empire.
All we've done is we've taken a concept that's always been there with the girls, guys, loving music, and loving great-looking people, and taking that forward and maybe change the music genre a little bit. But the bottom line is, the result's the same.
Pearlman has tapped into a gold mine, a teen market worth over $100 billion. Lou Pearlman makes stars.
Pearlman is the guy that ultimately gets the credit for Nsync and Backstreet Boys being as world famous as they are.
The Backstreet Boys, one of the top recording acts of all time. Their number one album in 1999 set a record for the most albums sold in the first week of release, over 12 million in the U.S., more than 23 million worldwide. Their 99 tours sold out in just 1 hour, and Black and Blue sold more than 8 million copies in the U.S. alone. Another monster success for Lou Pearlman and Transcontinental Records.
Please welcome Nsync.
Their album, No Strings Attached, set a record for the most albums sold in the first week of release, shattering the record previously held by the Backstreet Boys. It was the top-selling award-winning album of 2000. Combined sales of all Nsync albums totaled more than $570 million.
And the beat goes on. Lou Pearlman's Transcontinental Companies has just launched a nationwide talent search to cast a new boy band.
Who better to go to than Lou Pearlman to create a band for us?
MTV. Yeah! MTV.
With the hit series Making the Band, Transcontinental expanded its vision, moving from the top of the music charts to now include new triumphs in television.
'Cause I want it all, or nothing at all.
The show averaged 8.92 million viewers each week, topped its time slot in the desirable 18 to 24 demographic. And when the band's first single was released, it entered at number one on SoundScan and rose to number 10 on Billboard's Hot 100. And Lou Pearlman and Transcontinental continue making hits, like multi-platinum recording artist Aaron Carter. Aaron is known the world over and has accumulated more fans than he can count just by doing what comes naturally. Entertaining always surrounded Aaron, and you could say it was in his blood. His older brother Nick of the Backstreet Boys proves that musical talent runs in the family. As a member of New Kids on the Block, Jordan Knight toured the world stages and endeared millions of crazed fans. As seen on VH1's The Surreal Life, Knight is ready to embark upon the new phase of his already impressive recording career.
Please put your hands together.
With two gold U.S. singles and headlined, sold-out tours across Europe and Asia, Natural is taking the world by storm with its pop rock sound.
Days going by, I'm still the same.
These five guys are naturally gifted musicians, so the band certainly lives up to its name, Natural. Lou Pearlman and Transcontinental know how to get the attention of the entertainment industry and ignite the enthusiasm of the teen market.
From Louis J. Pearlman, the man who brought you the Backstreet Boys, Nsync, and from the hit series Making the Band, O-Town, comes his first feature film.
Their first feature movie, Long Shot, was packed with stars from Hollywood and the music scene. Long Shot proved that once again, Transcontinental could successfully cross into a new medium. Transcontinental Records is not just a leader in the music industry. It's a key player in the business world.
You use pretty much for the record company the business model that Motown used years ago, or even going back further, the model that Hollywood studios used, where you develop your own acts and you nurture them and bring them along and market them and do the whole number, don't you?
That's right. We have our own little boot camp down here.
Pearlman hires the best producers in the business and well-known songwriters to craft instant hits.
We learned a lot from Lou just in the beginning, being together and spending time with him. He's like, it's like this, and just talking over like percentages and how things work. And he kind of guided us and taught us a little bit about the business.
Lou is a pioneer, and he's a visionary. He's just a great mentor, and we appreciate his leadership skills.
They have asked Casey and I to come talk about Louis J. Pearlman, and quite honestly, I don't know Louis J. Pearlman. I know Lou Pearlman. He is a real visionary. And the difference between a dreamer and a visionary is a visionary puts his money where his mouth is. He knows what he wants, knows how to find it. Lou Pearlman is the essence of a visionary.
One company has the touch. One company has the total package of development, management, talent, production, promotion, and a core group of experienced executives who know the business. One company has produced over $1.8 billion in retail sales. That company is Transcontinental.